In this video, you're going to learn about the four support groups that you must create for yourself in order to be able to prepare, adapt, and overcome in the coming challenging times. Now, by the end of this workshop video, you will know exactly how to create those four groups, four support groups, who should be in those groups, how to communicate to them, and most important, how to make all those four groups working for you as a system, as a support system. So this is going to be a workshop video, which means you're going to do some work. So you'll need a pen and paper, preferably the printout of the PDF that the link is in the description below. So if you need a moment to get that, pause the video, go get this, and I'll see you on the other side. Ready? Great. So one of the major truths in life is that in order to create anything big in your life, into a major breakthrough or overcome a major crisis, like what's going to happen right now in our lives, we need to have our support system in place. It doesn't mean that you cannot do it alone, but it's a lot harder, it's a lot more painful, it's probably going to be a lot slower and, you know, a lot less fun, right? While when you have a support system, when you have the right support system, everything becomes easier, faster, much more powerful, and much more doable. In this workshop video, you're going to learn the four support groups that consist of this one support system. And they consist of different people, they have different purposes, and they have different schedules. And when you have all those in place, then preparing, adapting, and for sure overcoming these difficult times ahead is going to become a lot easier and doable for you. Are you ready? Let's go for it. Let's start with your inner circle. Inner circle, you probably already have, this is made from your close friends and family members, and they're there more or less on a daily basis for you. And the idea is that they are there for moral support mainly. So this is encouraging you when you need that, you know, that boost. They are there to cheer you up where you fall. They are there to pick you up and say, hey, it will be okay. So that's their main job. They don't really need to know or understand what is it that you're doing. Okay, that's not their job. But what you want them to do is to be there for you when you need them. And of course, you will be there for them in the same way. What is important is that you will take the time to communicate to them what type of support you need and how that support would look like. Sometimes we need a support in a form of a hey, it's okay, you know, don't worry, you know, I'm with you. Sometimes it's, hey, you know, wake up, you know, get up, you know, so what if something happened? Go back to work. It can be different, but you need to communicate it to them. You need to tell them what types of support you want and how do they look like. Okay, this is important. Now, before we move into the how, if some of your friends or close family members are non-supportive in any way, shape, or form, and that's probably going to happen to you in certain areas, then that's okay. Just don't get them involved. You don't have to get rid of them and not having them in your life. But when it comes to that topic that you need support, don't involve them. Get other people in your inner circle to help you. All right? So let's start by taking 2 minutes right now and write down all the people, the names of all the people that actually consist your inner circle, or you want to incorporate them into your inner circle, and what is it that you actually expect from them. Okay, so take 2 minutes to write that down right now. Thank you. Great. And now take 1 minute to actually commit for yourself. Write down when are you going to commit to contact them and how. So are you going to pick up the phone? Are you going to send them email? Are you going to make a family meeting and announce it? Whatever works for you, okay? 1 minute. When are you going to contact them and how? Let's move to level 2 in your support system, and that's your accountability buddy. Your accountability buddy can be a part of your inner circle. It can be a friend or a family member. Actually, two of my accountability buddies are a family member and a very, very good friend. But it doesn't have to be this way. If you're looking for an accountability buddy when it comes to your business, probably another entrepreneur which is thinking like you is a good accountability buddy. If you're trying to lose weight, maybe another overweight person that has the same goal and going on the same journey will be the right person for you. Accountability buddy is not there to be a friend. He or she has one role and one role only, to keep you accountable, and you do the same for them. So basically what it means is that you're going to share with each other or to commit to each other, this is what I'm going to do. Those are my goals, those are my actions. And then you're going to report back. This is what I did and this is what I accomplished. And you're going to stand there to make sure that that each one of you is actually committing and doing. That's it, nothing else. You don't have to ever meet in person. One of my accountability buddies lives on the other side of the world, and the last time we met was years ago. But you do need to meet regularly, at least once a week, by phone, by video chat, by WhatsApp, by email, whatever works for you. And I do regularly once a week, and if one of us needs something in between, then we do something short. We pick up the phone or we do a quick chat. I know also about people that are doing it once a week regularly, the meeting, and then every day or every night they are sending each other a report on what happened during the day with a WhatsApp or an email. Again, whatever works for you. The content of the meeting, if you want, is very, very simple. What I did and accomplished last week, what am I committing to do and accomplish next week? That's it. Anything else that you want to add for that is optional, and if you both agree with that, that's great. But this is the essence, and that needs to be in every single meeting. So now take 2 minutes to make a list of all those people in your life that you consider to be or to be a potential accountability buddy, and why they are the right person for the job. If you already have an accountability buddy, use those 2 minutes in order to have a look at the relationships that you created and see if you can improve anything, and write it down. All right, so now take 1 minute to write down when and how are you going to communicate to those people and ask them to become your accountability buddy. And if you already have an accountability buddy, then just take 1 minute to plan your improvement conversation. Take it now. So let's move on to level number three, and that's your mastermind group. Ideally, a mastermind group will consist of 4 to 8 people that are what we call like-minded people. They don't need to be the same age, they don't need to be the same gender, they don't need to have the same profession or the same business. Actually, the more diverse the people, the better, but they need to have a similar mindset, similar attitude, similar goals and values in life. Okay, so this is important. This group you want to meet, I would say every 4 weeks. So once a month you want to meet. If you meet online or offline, your choice. I had mastermind groups that were physically in the same place, and I had mastermind groups that people were all over the world and we met together over a video chat, okay? Whatever works for you. The purpose of mastermind group is to be a soundboard for your ideas and a safe space for brainstorming. If you can also in the same time have a chance to get some accountability buddies to support you in making sure that you're standing for your goals and some networking opportunities, those are bonuses. They are not a must, but those are absolutely extra bonuses. You can contact people in your social or your business network or environment. Remember, they don't have to be the same people as you, they just have to be like-minded. If you don't have those people around you, then feel free to contact people in the Soul Tribe. And those people that are watching these videos, those people that are following the same course, are ideal for that. They are all with the same mindset, same attitude, same goals and values as you. So the easiest would be to just scroll down under this video, watch their comments, read their comments, respond to their comments, and when you see somebody that you feel, hey, I have a connection or I can have a connection, then contact them and offer them to meet outside of this environment, so either online or offline, and just continue the conversation from there. See if you can build up together a mastermind group, all right? So take 2 minutes right now to list the names of all the potential people that you would like to contact for your mastermind group, and why do you think that they are the right people for that? I'm going to give you 2 minutes for that. Thank you. now take 1 minute to make a decision, a commitment. When are you going to contact these people and how? Are you going to do that by phone? Are you going to do that by LinkedIn? Are you going to do that by email? Whatever works for you, as long as you make the commitment and write it down for yourself. 1 minute. Alright, so if you wish to contact people from the Soul Tribe, then I'm going to give you right now 1 minute to actually post a comment and introduce yourself a little bit, say who you are and what are you looking for in people to join your mastermind group, and start the sentence, start your comment with looking for a mastermind group. So people, when they're scrolling through the comments, when they will see that if they're interested, they could contact you and see if you can build something together. Alright, take a minute for that right now. So let's move on to level number 4. Are you ready for it? Do you like it so far? So give me a like, okay? Before we move to level 4, just click the like button. This way I know that something that I'm doing is actually working for you. All right? Thank you for that. All right, so the level number 4 is your mentor, okay? Your mentor. Your mentor is not a coach. It's not an accountability buddy, and certainly it's not a friend. Okay, for me, the definition of a mentor is very, very, very simple. A mentor is someone that already achieved the goals that you are looking to manifest, looking to create in your life. That's it, nothing else. Okay, so that person in that field, in that area that you're interested in growing, in developing, in achieving your goals, if it's in business, if it's finances, if it's being a parent, if it's losing weight, if it's anything spiritual, health, whatever it is. Okay, so you're looking for that person that already achieved that, and you contact them and you ask them if they're willing to be your mentor. They might still be active in the area or not. Maybe they retired. They might be considering themselves as a mentor. They may be not. They might want to be compensated this way or another for being a mentor for you or not. I don't know this, and it's not so important. You're just looking for the right person, contact them and see how this relationship can evolve. Your mentor's role is to provide you with insights, with guidance, with feedback on how to achieve your goals in that area that you're asking them to mentor you. And they are not supposed to be your role models or mentors in any other area. So if you're looking for someone to be your business mentor, you don't look or judge them for how their health is or how their relationship are. It's not your business. You're looking for somebody that knows what they're talking about in business, and you're taking as much as you can in there, and that's it. Okay, this is important. People sometimes look for a mentor and they want him to be kind of enlightened in every single area of their life, and that's not going to happen, and it shouldn't happen. That's not their job. Ideally, you should meet online, offline, any way that works for you, every 4 to 6 weeks to discuss your plans, your ideas, your questions, your challenges, your situation in in the area that you're asking them for support. It's very important that for every meeting you will actually do four things. First, come prepared. Second one, don't waste the time. Third one, be respectful. And fourth one, show your gratefulness. And when you think about it, those four things should happen in every single one of the support groups you have, right? But here it's extra important because this is the only group, the only level when you're not equal. In all the other levels, if it's the inner circle, if it's the accountability buddy, if it's in the mastermind group, you're equal in the relationship with everybody else. Now you're not equal. They are here and you're looking up to them. So you better have all those four in place because otherwise you're going to lose them no matter how much you're going to pay for them. All right? Now, here's a pro tip for me, okay, what I learned through my life. You always, always, always want to have the best mentor you can afford. Which means for me that when I was poor and couldn't afford it, then I took somebody that was a little bit above me in their level, and they did it pretty much for free. But as soon as I could afford, I replaced that mentor with a mentor that was, you know, more advanced and knew more and had more vision and more connections and everything, and I paid more. And with the years, I kept on replacing or exchanging my mentors, going up all the time as my income went up. And that's in any area of your life, and that's important. Just remember that. Maybe it's too early for you, but remember. So now take 2 minutes to list down all the names of the people that you can consider or that you would like to consider to become your mentors. Not everyone is going to say yes, so you better have a list of those. And why each and every one of those is the right mentor for you. Take 2 minutes for that now. Great, and now take 1 minute to commit in your paper. When are you going to contact those people and how are you going to do that? Take 1 minute for that right now. Great, so you did quite a lot of work. Here's another pro tip. They might say no. And if they say no, instead of saying thank you, okay, sorry, instead of that, just ask them if they know anyone that they can recommend you as a mentor. And many times they would. All right, remember that. All right, so now take 2 minutes and let me know in the comment box below, what is the biggest takeaway that you take from this video lesson, and how are you going to actually implement that in your life? Okay, 2 minutes, your biggest takeaway, and how are you going to implement it in your life? That's your commitment to me, to the community, to yourself. I want to know. Let me know. Hey, you did that, and you are a superhero. Wonderful. So now you know what are the 4 levels of support that you need to create. You know how to create them, who to contact, when to contact, why you want to contact. Now it's up to you. So until we meet again, live fully, stay awesome, from Nisande.